Today we are going to discuss about KL transform, and other names given to this transform are what you can say the Hotelling transform, eigenvector transform, principal component transform, discrete KL transform. So these are the famous names, and this particular transform is based on statistical properties of vector representation. So in a vector form you will find or in the matrices form you many mathematical equations in this particular transform, and this particular transform has many useful properties. So it is very useful for image processing applications, and at the end of this particular transform we will talk about what are the applications, possible applications of this particular transform. So here the most important thing what I want to initially inform you is we are going to talk about the population of random vectors. Population of random vectors in the sense what I want to inform you, let's consider one example where we have seen many spectral images in the satellite data with the different wavelengths. You are obtaining many images. Let's say this is the first image of the first spectral because using some wavelength we got it. Then we have another, what you can say, the image. Then we have another image. Then we have another image. That means these are the different images of the same scene. So on the Earth surface, say for this particular area, this satellite is acquiring images with the different wavelengths. So the four, let's say the four different wavelengths are there, and we got for the same scene four different images: image 1, image 2, image 3, image 4. Okay, and here we have the different pixel values, pixel intensities. We have the different pixel intensities. So let's consider, we are talking now about the population of random vectors. Population of random vectors. And now let's say I am writing here a capital X equals to capital X equals to, let's say, the small x1, x2, up to xn. Okay, so here capital X indicates this is nothing but the population of random vectors collection. So this x1, let's consider this is, let's say, this pixel value. Okay, then we have this pixel value, this pixel, this pixel value. So this corresponding, that means the first pixel of each, if you are writing it here x1, x2, x3, xn, then we will say this is what you can say the first population collection we have, collection of the random vectors x1. Like this we can also create x2, capital x2, where we have another set of pixel values. Then we have capital X3, then another set of pixel values, like this. So what we are mentioning here, this is the population of random vectors, and in this particular form we are writing here. Which form I am talking about? Say this, just a minute. Say yes, this is the form we are using to represent what you can say the population of random vectors. And we can also obtain, we can also calculate mean vector of the population, and this I can write it here, let's say the small m and this capital X, and the expected value of this X, this in this way we can calculate the mean value, mean vector. So with this discussion we can go ahead with some important mathematical equations related to this. So whenever we are talking about the mean value, I can also write this mean value, what you can say, the representation in this particular format. Just observe now how I am writing here mean value. So mx, this capital X, equals to 1 by capital M summation k equal to 1 to capital M x k. Let's consider this is equation 1. Okay, so what this equation says, what this equation says, now just we discuss about the just discuss about the population of vector, different vectors are there, and let's consider for the time being here four different column vectors for explanation purpose how we are calculating mean value. So let's consider capital X1 first vector, its value here we have 0 0 0, then another vector we have there are the three values are here 1 0 0, then one more vector we have where we have value 1 1 0, and last vector in this example for the discussion 1 0 1. Okay, so using this mathematical model or equation 1, if you calculate mean value mx, what you will get here mx for this given population, total four different vectors are there, so 1 by 4, so this m indicates m is nothing but the 4, and when you sum up using this summation of individual 0 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1, that gives you 3, then you have 1 and then you will get 1. So this is the mean value, this is the mean value, got it. So in this way, very easily this mathematical equation related to the mean value calculation, all of you got the information about it. Now after calculating this, next task in this KL transform is about the covariance matrix. Initially we discussed that this is the in this transform you have the representation in the vector form or the matrices forms. So I am writing here Cx equals to 1 by capital M summation k equal to 1 to capital M xk and xk transpose minus mx mx transpose. Okay, say this is equation number 2 related to the covariance matrix calculation. And for now, you know xk, you know x, and you know mean value, so these things are known to you. So for this given, what you can say, example or the data, you can calculate very easily covariance matrix. And if you apply this equation 2 to above data, here for example, what you will get it 1 by 16 and in the matrix form 3 1 1 1 3 minus 1 1 minus 1 3, after calculation you will get it. Okay, so this is referred as the, what you can say, the covariance matrix. And here what you will observe, that diagonal elements are same of this matrix, that indicates that in this vector that indicates that the three components of the vector in the population have the same variance. Okay, so this is a covariance matrix for the given example, you got it. Now when you have this equation 1 and equation 2, then after that it is very easy for you to discuss about, what you can say, the Hotelling transforms equation or the KL transforms equation. Okay, so what I'm going to talk here is, now this equation y equals to a in the bracket x minus mx. Okay, so this is equation number 3, and this equation is referred as Hotelling transform equation. This equation is referred as Hotelling transform equation. So x is known to you, mx is known to you. What is a? A is a matrix whose rows are formed from the eigenvectors of covariance matrix. Okay, so whatever the covariance matrix, we got it from this, we will, let's say, we'll create a one matrix called the A, and here whatever is the first row has the highest, what you can say, the largest eigenvalue, that corresponds to the largest eigenvalue of the covariance matrix. First row of A corresponds to the largest eigenvalues of the covariance matrix, and the last row corresponds to the smallest eigenvalue of the covariance matrix. So you have A with you, and if you use this equation, then if you calculate this thing, this equation is referred as a Hodling transform equation. Okay, so these three equations we discussed in this model. Now, after this, when you talk about this y, when you talk about this y, so mean value, if you calculate m of y, you will observe it is equal to 0. Okay, and covariance matrix also can be calculated for later using this above equations A into Cx A transpose. This is for what you can say the, what is the y we got it related to the Hodling transform equations. And now when you observe here this Cy in a matrix form, what you will observe here in this, in the diagonal elements, I will get the all the eigenvalues, and off diagonal elements are 0. Off diagonal elements are 0. So this covariance matrix, off diagonal elements are 0, and so what you can say, the these elements of y are uncorrelated. So these three important equations, whatever we have just studied, are very useful to discuss Hodling transform. So whenever you are talking about the KL transform or the Hodling transform, eigenvalue transforms or the principal component transforms, you are talking about population of the vectors, and we just discuss with the help of this example, then calculate the mean value, and then equation 2 is helping you to calculate the covariance matrix, and when you have the covariance matrix, based upon that you calculate A matrix, and then you will write Hodling transform equation. And this Hodling transform equation is very useful for the different equations, different applications. And when we talk about applications related to what you can say this Hodling transform, so we can say that because of this eigenvalues related principal components we are calculating, so there are the many important applications are there of this Hodling transform. For example, we can use Hodling transform in the most of the image analysis applications, image analysis. Okay, and most of the time what happens in the image analysis also, few objects gets rotated, and if you want to remove what you can say the effects of this object rotation, effect of object rotation, then this transform is also very useful. Then many times what we do, we go for the approximation. Say we have the vector x, and then we have its approximated vector x. So in a Hodling transform, we, whatever the approximated vector we got it there, it is observed that its mean square error is very small. Mean square error is very small. So this is a very good application where we can say for the vector approximations we can use it. And this also can be used for the data compression applications. So there are the many such applications are there listed in the literature related to Hodling transform. So these were the few points related to KL transform or Hodling transform.